take down the first question based on self inductance. Define self inductance of a coil. Define self inductance of a coil. Write its SI unit. A plot of magnetic flux phi, next in the same question, a plot of magnetic flux versus current, or I'll write versus current is shown in the figure. Is shown in the figure for two inductors A and B. Which of the two has larger value of self inductance? Which of the two has larger value of self inductance? Okay, I'll read out once again. Define self inductance of a coil. Write its SI unit. A plot of magnetic flux versus current is shown in the figure for two inductors A and B. Which of the two has larger value of self inductance? Now you take down this graph first. Flux versus current, that is phi versus I graph. Okay, so the first question is define self inductance. This we have already seen when we did the theory part, that is about when we learnt about self inductance, but we'll write it once again. Self inductance of a coil is equal to the total magnetic flux linked with the coil and current through it is 1 ampere. We know the self inductance L is given by phi by I. So based on this, if I is equal to 1 ampere, then L is phi. Therefore, we can define the self inductance as L is the self inductance. The self inductance of a coil is equal to the total flux or total magnetic flux linked with the coil when unit current passes through it. L is phi, so it is equal to phi when the current passing through the coil is 1 ampere. This is one way to define the self inductance. Self inductance of a coil is equal to the total magnetic flux linked with the coil when unit current passes through it. Okay, self inductance of a coil is equal to the total magnetic flux linked with the coil when unit current passes through it. This is one way to define. You can also define in another way. We know the induced EMF is given by E is equal to L into di by dt. If di by dt is equal to 1 ampere per second, then E is equal to L. Therefore, I can say that self-inductance of a coil is equal to the induced EMF or EMF induced in the coil when rate of change of current is 1 ampere per second. This is another way to define. I'll write both the definition. You can write on any one. Self-inductance of a coil. Self-inductance of a coil is equal to the EMF induced in coil when rate of change of current in coil is one ampere per second. Self-inductance of a coil is equal to the EMF induced in the coil when the rate of change of current in the coil is 1 ampere per second. Now the next question is, what is its SI unit? Yes, you know the SI unit. It is Henry. SI unit of self inductance is Henry, and it is denoted by H. The symbol used is H. Now next question is, from this graph, you have to tell which one of these A and B are the two inductors. Now you have to tell which one has larger value of self-inductance. Now you know self-inductance is given by L is phi by I. Now this graph, if you see, it is flux versus I graph, phi versus I graph. Now, if you take the slope of this graph, that is phi by I, the slope of the graph, if you take, that actually gives the value of self-inductance. Once you find the slope of the graph, you will be able to tell which inductor has larger value of self-inductance. Why? Because the slope of the graph, which is nothing but phi by I, gives the value of self-inductance. So first we can write that as a note, like the slope of phi versus I graph gives the self-inductance of the coil. I'll draw the graph once again here in the next page. Now this is flux versus I, and we are asked to find out which inductor has larger value of self-inductance. To know that, we should know first what is self-inductance. We know L is phi by I. Now, phi by I is nothing but the slope of the given graph. Now, the slope of phi I graph gives self-inductance of a coil. Gives self-inductance of the coil or inductor. Now see these two graphs. So which has the greater slope? For same value of Y, or you know, I will draw like this. This is the y-axis, a line parallel to y-axis. and we'll draw another line parallel to x-axis. Now, which has the greater slope? Because it is a straight line, very simple one. Yes, the graph A has got greater slope when compared to B. Therefore, self-inductance of A is greater than self-inductance of B. This is how we are finding the slope. And this is a simple straight line. The curve A or slope of the curve A is greater. Slope of curve A is greater compared to curve B. Curve or straight line also you can write. Slope of curve A is greater compared to curve B. Therefore, self-inductance of A is greater than self-inductance of B. Therefore, self-inductance of A is greater than the self-inductance of B. Now, hope you understood this easily. We'll do another one, second problem. Current in a circuit falls steadily from 2 ampere to 0 amperes in 10 milliseconds. If an average EMF of 200 volt is induced, if an average EMF of 200 volts is induced, calculate the self-inductance of the circuit. Current in the circuit falls steadily from 2 ampere to 0 ampere in 10 milliseconds. If an average EMF of 200 volt is induced, calculate the self-inductance of the circuit. Now, first we'll write what are the given quantities. Now, given falls steadily from 2 ampere to 0 ampere. Therefore, initial current is given. Initial current, I can write I initial, that is 2 amperes. Then final current in the circuit is 0 ampere. Now the change in time, that is dt, is 10 milliseconds. Now you find out what is di, and the EMF induced is 200 volt. We know the equation E is minus L into di by dt, or the self-inductance L is E divided by di by dt. Now here the negative sign indicates or shows that the induced EMF opposes the very cause producing it, or the negative sign indicates the opposing nature of induced EMF. I'll put here also. Now this di, the rate of change of current, is IF minus II, so that is nothing but 0 minus 2, which is equal to minus 2 amperes. So that negative sign will get cancelled. Now L is 200 divided by minus di by dt. So it is 2 by 10 into 10 to the power minus 3. And this minus. Minus of minus will become plus. This will be equal to 200 divided by, so here minus of minus will become plus, and this is 10 into 10 to the power minus 3, that will become 10 to the power minus 2, so this will be 2 into 10 square, correct? Because 10, this will become 10 to the power minus 2, and when it goes to the numerator here, it will become 10 square. Or you can take to the numerator also, that here it will become 10 to the power minus 2. And finally it will be 1. L is 1 Henry. The self-inductance of the coil is 1 Henry. Self-inductance is 1 Henry. That completes this problem.